Welcome to the first episode of Sea Reporter. Today we are going to meet the damsel fish. I know, you've already seen this fish. In fact, every time you put your hand underwater. But how deep do you know this fish?
Stop talking, Matteo. What do you think?
You're right. Let's go!
In the temperate waters of the Mediterranean Sea lives the damselfish. It represents a key species in the Mediterranean rocky littoral, due to its great abundance and important role of planktivorous species involved in channeling nutrients from the pelagic system to the substratum. The Chromis chromis is a small fish, maximum 15 cm long, with unequivocal shape and color. It can be found above Posidonia meadows, from shallow waters to a depth of about 30 meters, and rocky reefs. During daylight, they feed in large aggregations near the water's surface, especially right after dawn and in the late afternoon. The fecal pellets released in the water are rich sources of nitrogen and phosphorus, and the portion deposited on the substratum attracts benthic organisms. That's the importance of the damselfish in providing nutrients, thus contributing to the sustenance of the marine ecosystem. On rocky areas, the damselfish takes advantage of other small fish that feed on parasites to be cleaned. Approaching the cleaning station, it stops and communicates it's ready for the treatment by assuming a vertical position.
Reproduction period starts from June to September. Males synchronously prepare nests, also called lairs, to court females and to take care of the eggs. The lair is about 2.5 meters square.
It is chosen by the nesting male on a solid substratum.
It can be a depression in a rock, a wreck, or like this ancient corner for fish farm. The nest can be in a vertical or horizontal position. The nest is cleaned by the male who removes alga with his mouth. During all the reproductive period, the nesting males exhibit aggressive behavior to defend their territory. When an intruder approaches, most of the time an individual of the same species, the male raises his dorsal fin. If the intruder remains close, the male engages a rapid chase. He swims rapidly towards the intruder with fast flickering movements of the caudal fin, causing the intruder to flee. When the nest is ready, the male can start to court females through a visual and acoustic display. He begins by swimming upward 1 to 3 meters to the lair, flickering rapidly the caudal fin. After, he returns to his lair, presses his belly against the rock and makes fast movements with the caudal fin while moving forward very slowly. While the males are nesting, females remain in the school in open water. They descend on the lair only to mate. Females become mature after 2 years. Their fecundity will increase with age and length. When a female is seduced by the male courtship, she leaves the school to join his new partner in the lair. They start to swim in circle, usually abreast or head to tail. gametes are released. It can last up to 15 minutes. Then the female will lay the eggs on the lair. The male will guard and fan them until the hatching. After that, they will leave the nest and join again the school. After the hatching, juveniles remain in aggregation close to the rocks, feeding on particulate matter. Most of the time, they are tolerated by adults. They are cobalt blue with iridescent electric blue. Growing up, they will become progressively darker from the tail to the head. During the dusk, the Mediterranean damselfish return to the rocks to find a safe place to sleep. Most of the time, it is into a small cavity. They sleep alone or by pair, with the dorsal fin erect. This is an intimidating posture, allowing to keep the intruders away.
Just like the entire marine environment, the Mediterranean damselfish is threatened by human presence. Bycatch and plastic ingestion are just some examples of the anthropogenic dangers it has to face during its life. Fortunately, it has learned how to take advantage of human wrecks, hiding inside them or scratching their surface to nest. But this species is also sensitive to a number of other anthropogenic pressures, most notably poor water quality and noise pollution. Nautical traffic can induce behavioral modifications in marine organisms. An increase of nautical traffic is followed by significantly less frequent foraging activity for the damselfish. The effect of noise in feeding behavior has repercussions on population dynamics. A decrease in number of individuals means a decrease in the benefits provided by the damselfish. For these reasons, the Mediterranean grommet is considered as an indicator of human pressure. Modifications of community structure could compromise the role of key species of the grommet, and obviously, the whole Mediterranean Sea.